For soldiers in the field, it can be difficult to handle an unidentified vehicle approaching a checkpoint. Disperse an angry crowd.
Deadly soldiers, éloignez-vous des soldats.
Or determine what an unknown person wants. But with the use of non-lethal weapons, soldiers can determine intent and gain compliance without hurting or even killing the people involved.
Anytime you can employ a non-lethal option, it's better than others. Obvious reasons. It's less damaging to infrastructure, buildings, surroundings, civilians, and it also kind of shows a path of goodwill to where we're operating in, opening up improved intelligence even.
It's my pleasure this morning to welcome you to the Connaught Range in Ottawa, Canada, where you are going to see NATO's largest non-lethal capability, a live fire demonstration.
As part of the NATO-sponsored North American technology demonstration in Canada, manufacturers showcased the latest non-lethal capabilities.
It is the largest non-lethal weapons showcase in the history of NATO. It's also an opportunity for us to take a look at some of the new hardware that's out there, some of the new tools that we can give to our soldiers to make them more effective in the battle space.
This is one of the newest technologies that is a projectile that contains the taser electronics that can be projected downrange from a low-speed grenade launcher. What this is designed to do is to be launched from that weapon platform, fly downrange and acquire a target individual. As it acquires that target individual, it's going to attach to them. When it attaches, a fracture disc will break and allow the projectile to separate away so that we can apply an electrical signal from the nose here, creating the hemi effect, the incapacitation, the physical incapacitation.
And although it is called the North American technology demonstration, there were also some Russian companies present.
Several Russian companies came here to present their products, and the representatives of the industry are working here, making contacts. This is really a good show and a good chance to present Russian products over here.
We're very proud of our partnership with Russia on this. Russia has been an active member of the Defense Against Terrorism Program of Work 11 since its inception 4 years ago. And I think it's indicative of the need to build bridges and develop good relationships with our partner nations.
The latest non-lethal tools that can be used in support of the ISAF mission in Afghanistan or counter-terrorism operations come in a wide variety, from flashbang grenades and riot nets to an active denial system that can repel adversaries by a focused energy beam.
Some of this stuff is cutting edge, not necessarily because it's a new concept, but it's a refinement of that concept. It's the stage two, the third generation of the concept, and every time it gets better.
As more and more commanders in the field are requesting better and less lethal capabilities, non-lethal weapons might become a game changer. I'm Carsten Reiniers, reporting for the NATO channel from Ottawa, Canada.